back at Dakota Arena. Carter Wishart being introduced as a starting goaltender for Chaska in our third game of the day. Chaska 5-4 winner over Prior Lake. And today they get their toughest test of the season in the form of Eden Prairie. Chaska 5-5-1 on the year. Eden Prairie 7 wins, no losses, and their first tie of the season yesterday against St. Thomas Academy here on this ice. Now we'll get the introduction of the starting lineups for Eden Prairie. And Axel Rosenlund gets the start for them. He played yesterday against St. Thomas Academy. Mason Langenbrunner getting the start on defense. Junior. And his defense partner is Cam Langfels, another junior. Drew Holt, junior, getting the start at forward for Eden Prairie. Riku Brown. The wing on that line, and Carter Batchelder, all junior group there in goal, the exception for Eden Prairie, the exception of the goaltender. Eden Prairie 7-0-1, Chaska 5-5-1 next after this on the Youth Hockey Hub.
It's not uncommon to see NHL stars walking through our halls.
What I need, what I think NHL players need, I think it's the premier, it's as good as it gets.
If you look out there, there's, you know, 15 to 20 NHL guys any day could be skating.
But they don't sign autographs.
Ready, go!
They're here for the same reason you are. They're a reflection of what passion, hard work, and determination can become.
About 4 years ago, Wicked Rags changed my life. I am a mother of three hockey-playing children. The Sock Jock is amazing. It allows children to get dressed on their own and be independent in their hockey career. When you average 3 to 4 practices a night, and this product saves you 5 minutes getting dressed and getting undressed, you do the math. I highly recommend it and think it's incredible.
4 years ago, the open field behind Alexandria High School in Alexandria, Minnesota was vacant. The open space abutted by Pioneer Road was nothing more than something to ignore as residents of Alex moved past on their way to two churches, the Midway 9 movie theater, or the Joann Fabrics. But over time, the meadow, which the developers rejected, has become the cornerstone. Under the guidance of Rick and Shannon Randazzo, the North Star Christian Academy has gone from a concept born almost 10 years ago to a rising hockey power in the middle of Minnesota's Central Lakes region.
Back at Dakota Arena, starting goaltenders for this game, Axel Rosenlund for Eden Prairie, 5-0-1, 8 goals against. Eden Prairie's only allowed 10 goals all season long. 152 saves, 160 shots, 1.30 goals against average, 95% save total and 2 shutouts. And for Chaska in goal, it's freshman Carter Wishart, 5-5-1, 3.09 goals against average. 33 goals against on 260 shots, 87.3 save percentage, and he has 2 shutouts. As we get ready to start this game, Chaska in the purple working left to right as we call the first period for you. Jeff Papas on the call as we get in the evening session. We pass the halfway mark in this event. Start of game number 7. It comes on to the Eden Prairie goal. And now play it on out to center and relayed back by Chaska's Shane Lavelle, number 21. Langfels behind the goal for Eden Prairie. Near side for Riku Brown. And that's disrupted on the near side by Charlie Goodrich for the Hawks. It goes back behind the net. And loose at the right edge. And Goodrich tried to find a way through to goal. No such luck. And it comes back to Burkholder at the blue line. And out to center. It's played in rink wide by Burkholder. Heads for the bench as Chaska gets a change. Mason Langenbrunner gets his first touch behind the goal. Comes out to the near side and feeds Brown. Out to center, here's Batchelder, and it's stripped off his stick by Jimmy Snuggerud, the freshman scoring leader for Chaska. Puck played to center, picked up by Luke Middlestad, number 27. Fed off to the far side. Drew Holt back over to Middlestad. Now Headmans, and it's picked up there by Ben Steves, leading scorer of this team with 13 points. Played in, rink wide to the near side, and the carom off the wall, comes back to the far side, chasing after it for Eden Prairie. Stansberry along the wall. He feeds it down for Steves in the corner. Steves is taken in against the boards by Nick Olmscheid, and now a centering pass hits the back of the net. And here's a shot from a sharp angle. Wishart makes a save on Stansberry, and the puck is played back into the Eden Prairie zone. Going back for it, Luke Mittelstad on the turn. A minute and a half gone in the first period. Luke Mittelstad to the far side, and it's John Mittelstad over the line, cuts to the slot, and then feeds the puck to the far side. Steves takes a shot that's over the top of the net. The long carom comes back in the Eden Prairie zone, and chasing back for it is Will Britton in the left corner. He works against Bennett Jacks around the far side, and Stansberry plays the center, and that's cut off. Chaska's Bauer Berry, 28, now played it in rink wide. Now picked up in the near circle of the Eden Prairie zone by Steves, and he plays it off to the right. Picked up there by Magnuson for Chaska. Now to Bennett Jacks at the blue line, who backtracks into his zone, fans on it, and comes back for it. Bennett Jacks back around behind the net on the near side, and the Hawks will try that side. Rinzel feeds it across to the far side, and here comes Chaska over the line, played to the area behind the net by Owen Thomas, and now Tyler Johnson for Eden Prairie plays it up the wing, and down come the Eagles over the line. Puck to the far boards, Canyon Pergan feeds it to the left of the goal, centering pass hits the back, and now Eden Prairie gets possession along the wall, spin and shoot, and Wishart with the save, and the puck played to the far side wall, picked up there by Reagan Shepard. Now to the right point, comes to the near side, Langfels closes in, the shot goes wide, loose to the boards on the far side, and Goodrich will play it to center, picked up by Sully Scully for Chaska, and he shoots it on in, chases after it, and he's in a race there with Langfels behind the net. Now the puck comes to the far side wall. Batchelder tips it forward, played back by Lavelle for Chaska. Threw it in front, and that's intercepted. Here comes Langfels back for Eden Prairie. Over the line, backhands it forward, deep into the Chaska zone. Calvin Barrett goes to the corner, but he's a step slow. Comes to the corner wall, and players from both teams will slap for it. Now here's Batchelder missing wide to the right, and it comes off the boards, picked up by Luke Mittelstad, and then played out to center. Langfels from the red line, rink wides it back in. 3.5 gone in the first period. Play behind the Chaska goal. It's cleared around to the near side wall, and it's picked up there by Zach Stelton, who plays it to the high slot. Holt there to pick it off and turn it back. Luke Mittelstad, top of the circle for Eden Prairie. He takes it in deep. He centers it, and it's steered away by Chaska's Lavelle to the near side. Now they come to center. It's picked up by Stelton, and I'll play it out rink wide to the far side, and there is Batchelder to pick it up. He sends his man away, Riku Brown, over the line. Holt to Brown, they score! A little two-on-one, and Riku Brown has scored for Eden Prairie at the four-minute mark. And they go ahead 1-0, exactly 4 minutes into the game. Riku Brown, and a nice little give-and-go there, worked with Drew Holt. And Eden Prairie has a 1-0 lead. Brown's third goal of the season.
Eden Prairie goal, scoreman number 21, Riku Brown. Assist to number 8, Drew Holt, and number 11, Carter Batchelder.
And Batchelder got an assist on that, but shouldn't, as the play was a three-way passing play between Riku Brown and Drew Holt. But it goes on the score sheet as an assist, and they get a point on the score sheet that way. Played back in the Chaska zone, picked up by Magnuson. In the left corner, his outlet pass comes right back to him off an Eden Prairie skate. Now banked ahead to center. And Chaska has to come back and regroup for it. They give up a two-on-one. Here's Steves. He's in deep. He's working there against Will Magnuson behind the net. Nice play by Magnuson. And now picked up and relayed on out by Berry to center. Chaska trying to find some space. Owen Thomas played it forward. And Eden Prairie will backtrack into their zone. Steves feeds the right. And now played ahead and into the zone by Stansberry. It'll come back behind the net. And out of the far side, along the far wall, Chaska's Berry plays it back into the Eden Prairie zone, but it's icing. So we'll go back for a face-off. We've played 4:52 of the first period of game number 3. And it is 1-0. For Eden Prairie. Riku Brown with a goal. And it'll be Pergand on for the faceoff against Snuggerud. And Jimmy Snuggerud won the draw there, comes to the left edge of the goal. And Eden Prairie's Calvin Barrett behind the net, feeds the far side. And out to center it comes. Here's Selton at the red line to Snuggerud over the Eden Prairie line. Poke checked off his stick, can't touch it. And now comes back. And here comes Eden Prairie over the line. A shot right on and a save made by Carter Wishart on Canyon Pergand. We had talked about it yesterday. We'll mention it again. Jimmy Snuggerud, the son of the head coach, Dave Snuggerud for Chaska, the former NHL player and Minnesota Gopher. Some good bloodlines there, and Snuggerud leads his team in scoring as a freshman. Now Barrett in the left corner. And a goal yesterday did Jimmy Snuggerud and an assist. Here's a shot from the near circle wide by Langfels. And Langenbrunner will play it back out to center. Now played into the zone. It's touched and it's offside. And of course, he's not the only player with an NHL dad, Mason Langenbrunner of Eden Prairie. His father is Jamie, former Dallas Star, St. Louis Blue, New Jersey Devil, and U.S. national team captain, among other things. From the faceoff, it is Rinzel back in his zone for Chaska, feeding the far side. And it's now played into the zone. Come back behind the net. Langenbrunner is beaten there by Shane Lavelle. Now as he falls, it's played ahead by Brown to center. Over the line, Holt. Broken up there, and Chaska comes back. They have a 3-on-2 if they hurry. And it's picked up by Lavelle, and the back-checking defender got the back Batchelder in a big hurry and stopped that odd man rush. Now here comes Eden Prairie down the wing. This is Steves over the line to Batchelder, played in deep. And Lavelle tries to play it behind the goal. Burkholder goes behind the net, swings to the near side for Rinzel. And it's flipped high in the air. It comes down in over the glass and out of play. 10:35 to go in the first. Shots are 3-0. Eden Prairie in the early going. Faceoff will be taken in the Chaska zone to the right of Wishart. The freshman goaltenders had quite a baptism. Chaska plays a difficult schedule, and have the freshman goaltender. He is learning against the best. Comes out to center, and Luke Mittelstad rink wides it back into the zone. Joe Lynch for Chaska feeds the near side for Burkholder. Pass up the middle, and it's tipped past Bauer Berry, and he will go the distance. No icing there. Puck comes to the near wall, picked up by Reagan Shepherd along the wall. He lost possession. Shot from a sharp angle over the top by Jax. Played to the left point, and now it's played down by Lynch behind the net. Jax looking for help in front. He was headed off there, comes to the far side, and it's picked up, played ahead by Tyler Johnson to center for Eden Prairie. Played in by Pergand, and then he wheels for the bench as they change. Chaska gets the puck in the left corner, and it's played ahead through the skates of Barry. It'll go the length of the ice, and that will be icing on Chaska. 9:46 to go in the first. They're still looking for their first shot on goal. But Chaska trailing 1-0 here in the early going. They have had games. They played Blake. They played Lakeville North, who we saw in this tournament, lost 5-2 in that game. They have played Rosemount, lost that game 7-0. They played Buffalo with a decent team, and they lost 6-4 at Minnetonka. Here's a centering pass, and a shot that goes wide from Will Britton from the faceoff as Eden Prairie applies more pressure along the wall. It's John Mittelstad playing it behind the net. Stansberry plays to the far side, gets it back, and then it ran past him. Sam Rinzel feeds the near circle for Selton, and it comes to center. Here comes Snuggerud over the line. He takes a shot, and it was over the top of the cage. It rings the boards on the dasher and comes out to center. Now controlled by Snuggerud, and he's right back in over the line. Jimmy Snuggerud centers it, went right through the feet of Olmscheid in front of the goal. Now cleared off to the far side, and here comes Stansberry over the line for Eden Prairie. And he leaves it. John Mittelstad back to Stansberry, to Mittelstad. In the corner, it's stripped away, and Jimmy Snuggerud starts back for Chaska. Comes to the red line. He'll carry over the line. Snuggerud cuts to the slot, still in possession, left a drop. Here's a shot, and a save by Barrett, a save on Barrett, rather, by the goaltender Axel Rosenlund. Now a steal in down low, and here's a spin and shoot as Barrett is stopped by the goaltender. Rosenlund again with a save. 8.5 to go in the first period. Halfway through it, Eden Prairie leads 1-0. And it's picked up there by Mason Langenbrunner. Feeds the left. Now Langfell steps through center. Feeds to the right. Eden Prairie will gain the zone. A drop pass to Batchelder. Played down low and centered, and Brown tips it through the crease to the near side boards. Here comes Chaska back to center. Burkholder carries over the line, tries to split the defense, and he's ridden off. Batchelder behind the goal, feeds the near side, and Brown controls. Fanned on his clearing attempt, and it's flipped back behind the net by Goodrich for Chaska. Now a rough ride given along the boards for Scully, but he gets the puck anyway in the corner. Then he runs into the referee, and he finds that a little bit more difficult. The referee has to step through, and it's loose to the far side. Scully finally lost possession of the puck, and Eden Prairie will pick it up. They'll come out 3-on-3. Brown over the line, leaves a drop pass up the slot, tipped off the stick of Holt, and we get a whistle, and behind the play we are going to have a penalty, an interference penalty coming up at the 9:24 mark. And it's going to go against Eden Prairie. Chaska will get the game's first power play. Batchelder heading to the box. Chaska power play. Their first of the game. And they convert at 30%. Eden Prairie's penalty kill has been excellent. 92.6% on the year. Faceoff win for the Hawks. Now, Chaska at the right point, and this is Magnuson. Plays to the high slot, and it's Burkholder. Over to the left side, now gets it back. Top of the slot, takes a shot, deflected wide. Comes to the near boards, and Snuggerud is able to hold it in on the wall. Then he dives to block a clearing attempt, and finally the Eagles do get it and clear it past Burkholder all the way down the ice. Wishart will set it up, and he feeds the near side. It's tipped to the line and held in there by Steves. And now that's going to force Selton to come back and gain possession. He gets some help from his friends, and now the puck's dug out. Here's Jimmy Snuggerud. Minute 18 on the power play. Snuggerud leaves the drop for Burkholder. And the sophomore Max Burkholder comes over the line, splits the defense, and then goes down. And play picked up in the left corner of the Eden Prairie zone, flipped high in the air and all the way down the ice. After it there is Magnuson in the left corner. Eden Prairie getting a change. Chaska changing most of its power play unit. And now spinning back in the zone is Calvin Barrett. Leaves a drop, and now having some trouble is Magnuson, but he gets away. Bill Magnuson down the near wing. Check that, Lavelle over the line. It's poke checked off his stick, but Chaska will hold the zone and loose along the boards to Bauer Berry. Now players from both teams in. It's dug out by Barrett. High slot, winds up, shoots, and he didn't miss by much there. Boy, he got something on that shot. As it comes around behind the net, Lavelle looking to center. It comes back to Barrett at the point. Feeds it across to the left, 28 in the power play. Here's Calvin Barrett high in the slot. Near circle, gets it back on a one-touch pass from Scully. Works to the right, he shoots, and a save made by Rosenlund. Faceoff coming up in the Eden Prairie zone. 5:55 to go in the first half. Chaska 5-5-1 on the season. Their first game here yesterday, they defeated Prior Lake by 5-4 in a game that saw them score with the goaltender off for an extra skater and a minute 10 to go, and then winning in overtime. So a good win for Chaska. It's the only time they led in the game was at the end, which is really the only time you need to be leading, frankly. And here's John Mittelstad playing at the center, and he tips it back into the Chaska zone. Here's a race for it. Steves will get there first for the Eagles as the penalty comes to an end. And now a pass to the left, and here comes Chaska. Dodging and weaving through center is Jimmy Snuggerud. Over the line he comes. Snuggerud fakes a shot, comes to the circle, then he shoots, and a save made. Rebound loose at the left edge, and they score, but the whistle had gone. Zach Selton scored, but the referee lost sight of the puck and had blown play dead, and there's no goal. So Zach Selton had the puck in the net, and the puck not frozen, but the referee behind the net lost sight of it, so he blew it dead. And we'll have a face-off in the Eden Prairie zone. And they're going to get a whistle here and a break in the action. Dave Snuggerud would like an explanation. Doesn't look real happy. Look at him on the bench getting an explanation from the referee. He was standing behind the goaltender, behind the goal line. So when the puck was laying in front of the goaltender, Rosenlund, naturally he couldn't see it. His sightline was blocked by the goaltender, and he blows play dead when he loses sight of the puck. So faceoff coming up. Snuggerud on the draw for Chaska, lost it, and Eden Prairie gains control. Played around to the far side and out to center for Magnuson. 5:17 to go in the first. Burkholder back over to Magnuson on the far side. Back to Burkholder. And here comes Chaska. Burkholder over the line. Plays it over the line. Still in possession. Tried to split the defense. Goes to the right. Spins and shoots. And a save made by Rosenlund. Rebound is onto him. And the goaltender gets a stoppage. So Chaska coming alive here after losing a goal to a disallowed call by the referee. And you can go ahead and say it. I'm not taking a side, but it was a quick whistle. And with 5:01 to go in the period, Chaska trying to figure out what they're going to do about it. Here's Busby for Eden Prairie. Lost possession to Owen Thomas, and now it's cleared down the far side. Eden Prairie will break out three wide over the middle. Here's Luke Middlesteady at the post on the left. Boy, a cranked off wrist shot there. Now it's played by Busby. And it came out. It's got an offside called. We'll get a faceoff at neutral ice, but boy, a solid goalpost there. And Eden Prairie nearly doubled its lead. Faceoff will come outside. And the draw won by Chaska. Played into the Eden Prairie zone. Luke Middlestad there against Barry. Now the puck is picked up. And Eden Prairie lets it run in their zone. They'll pick it up at center. Played off by Busby to the far side. Shepard, check that, Jorgensen going in deep. Swings around to the near side looking to center it. Still has the puck on the wall. Now to Luke Middlestad. Hopped his stick and he has to back out. Middlestad takes a whack there from Bennett Jacks. Puck come free back into the Eden Prairie zone. Right onto Rosenlund. Makes a save. Luke Middlestad behind the net with 4:15 to go in the first. And he's to the far wall. He'll bank it down to center ice. Played back to the near side. Chaska in possession. And here's Rinzel playing it in. It'll come onto the goaltender. Rosen lets it bounce in front of him. And then it's played over Rinzel, who leaped to try to knock the puck back into play. And it's not going to go far enough for icing. Now in the right corner, Chaska will try to step through. Here's Magnuson playing it ahead. And here's Scully down the near wing. Puck comes to the middle of the rink. And it's played back by Jorgensen to the near side. Good forecheck by Chaska as Scully tries to play it back in, has it at the line, and then swings it around on the boards. It'll ring the boards on the dasher and played over to the far side by Langfels. Now Holt for Eden Prairie. Plays it ahead. It gets past Lavelle and comes out to center. Here's Rinzel. Rink wide to the near side to Burkholder for Chaska. Back over to Rinzel. 3:25 to play in the first period. Pass to the center circle is a little bit lax, and Holt tipped it forward. Batchelder backtracks, now feeds the near side, and it's played ahead by Brown to the line, picked up by Burkholder, and he sends his man away. Here's a drive right on, a save made, rebound. It comes in front, Chaska buzzing again, and it was Scully with a couple of opportunities to get the game tied here with 3 minutes to go in the period. Here's Brown feeding it ahead, and now Eden Prairie comes to center. Here's Batchelder down the near wing. Feeds it across to the right. Langenbrunner, his shot is blocked and over the glass and out of play by Joe Lynch. We'll get a faceoff with 2:53 to go in the first. Shots in the period now are 9-3 for Chaska, which means they've had the last nine shots on goal in this period. Eden Prairie got the first three and hasn't had one since. They lead 1-0. Of course, they also had a goalpost in there too, so which doesn't count as a shot, but for purposes of accuracy, we strive for all the time. The puck comes out to center. Here comes Chaska, Snuggerud over the line. He takes a shot, and he had the goaltender ducking there. Puck comes to the point area and runs on out to center. And we get a whistle, and we're going to take a faceoff back deep in the Eden Prairie zone. 2:36 to go in the first period. Riku Brown, the only goal of this game, it came exactly 4 minutes in. Now played from the draw around by Busby to the near side. Going to run to the wall. Snuggerud trying to free it up, and he does. Jimmy Snuggerud is then checked off the puck. John Middlestad back for it. Now Olmscheid forced him into a turnover, and it came on to Rosenlund, who got a stoppage. And that kills a little bit of time. 2:22 to go. One more game coming up tonight, and it is Edina versus St. Thomas Academy, scheduled to start at 7:30. That should be a good one as well, St. Thomas Academy. But Edina comes into this game below 500, having lost last night in overtime to Moorhead. Barrett along the far half wall for Chaska. They've done a good job here in the first period. Here's a shot, and it goes wide of the goal by Barry. Score! Rebound off the inboards! And Chaska's got the game tied with 2:09 to go in the first period. A crazy hop off the boards. And it is tucked home. Bennett Jacks. And we're tied at one. Time of the goal, 14 minutes and 51 seconds. Bennett Jacks for Chaska. Would be his first goal of the season.
Chaska goal, scored by number 12, Jacks.
And a big hit thrown. And now here they come in again. It comes to the left edge of the goal, as Chaska's Bauer Berry came close. 1:49 to play in the first period. A 1-1 score. Bennett Jacks scoring the goal. And now behind the net, Langenbrunner for Eden Prairie. And Chaska's first period has been strong. They've outshot Eden Prairie 10-3. Here's Brown over the line, leaves it for Batchelder, and then catches up to it, feeds it over to the far side for Drew Holt. And body's starting to fly a little bit. Chaska with some belief here. 1:20 to go, and they play it up the middle. Here they come. Scully over the line, tries to split the defense, and picking it up and almost finding a shot was Goodrich. With a minute 12 to go, here comes Eden Prairie's Holt over the line. He's harassed from behind, forced wide, and now it's picked up by Batchelder on the far wall for Eden Prairie. Swings to the slot area, and it runs to the slot. Batchelder, his shot was partially deflected. Last minute of play in the period. And now the puck runs to the near side boards. Luke Middlestead there to help, but the puck comes to the right side instead, and a shot is deflected by the defense wide. Busby took it. Here's Busby again at the right point with 45 seconds to go in the period. Now along the wall, a shot blocked off the stick of John Middlestead and back out to center. Luke Middlestead for Eden Prairie plays it back as he takes a swipe from Goodrich, shoots it back in. Goaltender missed the cutoff. Ring back around on the near side, looking for Selton for Chaska. It's stolen away, going in on the backhand. Steves, his shot is blocked. He gets it back with 20 seconds to go. Luke Middlestad closes in. He takes a shot, and that has everyone ducking. Puck comes to the right point, and Busby holds it in there, plays it around behind the net, looking for Stansberry. He's got him, and now feeds off to the left wall, picked up by Lavelle for Chaska, and it's played to center with 8 seconds to go, and we're going to go to intermission with a 1-1 tie after the first period. Chaska and Eden Prairie here from the Dakota Arena. Shots on goal in the first period favored Chaska 10-3. I want to get the assist. I missed the assist on the Chaska goal. Let's see who they give that to. The goal was to Bennett Jacks. And Owen Thomas is given the assist on the Chaska goal that tied the game by Bennett Jacks. That is his first goal of the season. Shots 10-3 for Chaska. We'll take a break and come back with our second period next. You're enjoying the Hockey for Life 2019 Classic on the Youth Hockey Hub.
It's not uncommon to see NHL stars walking through our halls.
What I need, what I think NHL players need, I think it's the premier. It's as good as it gets.
If you look out there, there's 15 to 20 NHL guys any day could be skating.
But they don't sign autographs.
Ready, go!
They're here for the same reason you are. They're a reflection of what passion, hard work, and determination can become.
The younger kids can see what we're doing, and they can see what the older kids are doing, and emulate that to see what it takes to get to the next level.
MAP is the premier hockey development program in the Twin Cities, and the reasons are very clear.
I like coming to MAP because it's very competitive. Everybody comes out here, works their best.
The opportunity is here to take advantage of whatever the individual wants to take advantage of, whether it's on ice, off ice, outside shooting.
You have everything at your fingertips that you need to be, premier athlete and hockey player.
The intensity is really high, and every day it seems like players are getting better.
Our culture is unique. From peewee to professionals, we demand the same effort from every athlete. And every athlete receives the same world-class treatment.
At MAP Hockey, our sole emphasis should be and is developing high-character athletes.
Our dedicated, decorated staff will help bring your best to the forefront, both on and off the ice.
That competitive atmosphere that we have here is something special.
It's fun seeing the kids work just as hard as we are.
Red, white, blue. Here we go. Let's go.
At MAP Hockey, we are fully supportive and aligned with the Minnesota Development Model. We encourage athletes to stay home, develop their skills, and play for their community.
We want to put every kid in a position to have success. We kind of put the emphasis on the individual to, you know, create their own career.
When you walk through these doors, be ready to commit to something bigger than yourself.
I'm TJ Oshie, and this is MAP Hockey.
I'm Justin Falk, and this is MAP Hockey.
I'm JT Brown, and this is MAP Hockey.
This is MAP Hockey.
Four years ago, the open field behind Alexandria High School in Alexandria, Minnesota was vacant. The open space abutted by Pioneer Road was nothing more than something to ignore as residents of Alex moved past on their way to two churches, the Midway 9 movie theater, or the Joann Fabrics. But over time, the meadow, which the developers rejected, has become the cornerstone. Under the guidance of Rick and Shannon Randazzo, the North Star Christian Academy has gone from a concept born almost 10 years ago to a rising hockey power in the middle of Minnesota's Central Lakes region.
In 2011, my family and I voyaged out on the 50-state, 50-city tour, which brought our family to all 50 states for 30 days, running hockey camps for youth and adults. A year or so went by, and it brought us to 2013. We were here in Minnesota, and I met with some businessmen, some couples at Tim Cullen's house, and the rest of the story was then became a little bit clearer.
There are 25 players taking classes and playing for the North Star Christian Academy team, hailing from 11 states. North Star's academic team ensures the students are meeting the education requirements for high school graduation, with some students even earning college credit along the way.
So our academic program is very unique in a way because we're bringing in players from all over the country. This year we have 12 different states represented, which means we have to take a look at 12 different high school programs that are going on across the country. We take a look at where the players are at. We try and integrate where they're at to where they want to be. We look forward to the academic goals that they may have, also along with the college goals that they have.
Since coming to North Star, my hockey has just developed and improved tremendously. And before in Fargo, I maybe could have played Division I and gotten noticed, but the chances wouldn't have been as high as when I came here. And now I'm getting a lot more attention and looks, and hopefully my chances to play Division I are a lot higher. So,
while North Star Christian Academy prides itself on a successful hockey start, the development of the whole person is the primary goal of the little school in Alexandria.
So I think that the three main levels of growth that I've had in my life would be the three pillars that we base the school bases itself off of, which is faith, school, and hockey. And I think those have been massive. I think, especially in faith, I mean, we wake up every morning at 7 in the morning and we have a Devo every morning. So that's huge. Then we're on the ice 2.5 to 3 hours a day. And then we're in the classroom for 5. So we're learning and we're growing in all aspects of our life all the time.
It's a full life for North Star Christian athletes. The Academy's 70,000 square foot athletic facility not only gives the players a place to hone their skills, but it's a touch point for the rest of their day. Serving something higher than yourself takes discipline, sacrifice, and commitment. With the schedules of that Tier 1 teams follow, it would be easy for the players and administrators to lose sight of the Academy's original goal. But between classes, hockey, and traveling around the country for competition, the Knights make it a priority to remind themselves of their ultimate focus.
It's not uncommon to see NHL stars walking through our halls.
What I need, what I think NHL players need, I think it's the premier, it's as good as it gets.
If you look out there, there's 15 to 20 NHL guys any day could be skating.
But they don't sign autographs.
Ready, go!
They're here for the same reason you are. They're a reflection of what passion, hard work, and determination can become.
The younger kids can see what we're doing, and they can see what the older kids are doing, and emulate that to see what it takes to get to the next level.
MAP is the premier hockey development program in the Twin Cities, and the reasons are very clear.
I like coming to MAP because it's very competitive. Everybody comes out here, works their best.
The opportunity is here to take advantage of whatever the individual wants to take advantage of, whether it's on ice, off ice, outside shooting.
So you have everything at your fingertips that you need to be, premier athlete and hockey player.
The intensity is really high, and every day it seems like players are getting better.
Our culture is unique. From peewee to professionals, we demand the same effort from every athlete. And every athlete receives the same world-class treatment.
At MAP Hockey, our sole emphasis should be and is developing high-character athletes.
Our dedicated, decorated staff will help bring your best to the forefront, both on and off the ice.
That competitive atmosphere that we have here is something special.
It's fun seeing the kids work just as hard as we are.
Red, white, blue. Here we go. Let's go.
At MAP Hockey, we are fully supportive and aligned with the Minnesota development model. We encourage athletes to stay home, develop their skills, and play for their community.
We want to put every kid in a position to have success. We kind of put the emphasis on the individual to, create their own career.
When you walk through these doors, be ready to commit to something bigger than yourself.
I'm TJ Oshie, and this is MAP Hockey.
I'm Justin Falk, and this is MAP Hockey.
I'm JT Brown, and this is MAP Hockey.
This is MAP Hockey.
back at Dakota Arena, ready for period number two, a 1-1 tie. Jeff Papas with you as we have game number seven well underway, and we want to say hello. And we will do that on the Youth Hockey Hub if we are asked very nicely. And, in fact, we were. We want to give a shout-out to Steve Scholey, who's watching the game. He is Sully's grandfather watching the game at Leech Lake. And there's a shot from the faceoff, and Batchelder came close to tying the game while I was saying hi. And now it comes out to center. But, Steve, we're glad you're watching on the Youth Hockey Hub. Glad to have you along. And everyone who's watching this game, as a matter of fact. Puck is played all the way back into the Eden Prairie zone. An immediate icing call against Chaska. 16:28 to play in period number two. Eden Prairie and Chaska locked at one. See if we can get some other scores here from around the state on this second day of the holiday tournaments. From the faceoff, Eden Prairie wins the draw. Luke Middlestad at the left point takes a shot, and really Wisher not much of an idea there as the puck was deflected wide of the post. Puck comes out to center, and Luke Middlestad rings it back in. Wishart sets and comes to the near corner and played back behind the net. Joe Lynch for Chaska feeds the far side. Middlestad shoots, save made, and the puck comes to the right boards, and Selton plays it ahead, and it's relayed back down the ice. And Snuggerud chasing after. He will get there first. Tries to come in front. And now back out to center it comes. Lynch for Chaska. Plays it back into the zone. Picked off by Luke Middlestad. And now it's played into the Chaska zone. And they wave off icing. And it's going to be Stansberry getting there. He feeds the near circle for John Middlestad. Now here's a shot. And that's stopped. And Steves took it. Wishart made the save. And knocked it over the top of the net. Now here's Steves again. Reverses, comes around to the far side, and here is Britton for Eden Prairie. Plays it towards the net, and now Stansberry back off to the far wall. Selton trying to clear the zone for Chaska, and now he will, and he angles one out to center, and Nick Olmscheid over the line. He goes down, penalty on Eden Prairie coming, and Will Britton can't believe it. He doesn't look too happy as he is heading off to the penalty box. It'll be a power play for Chaska at 1:53. And it's power play number two. For the Hawks, 0-for-1 so far, trying to snap a 1-1 tie. Play to the left corner, and Chaska gets control. Tripping is the penalty, and the Hawks have the man advantage. And it comes out to center. Chasing it back down is Lavelle. The goaltender's a way out, and now it's played back to the left corner. Owen Thomas, rink-wide pass, and now Chaska will come to center. Pass deflected onto the stick of Langenbrunner, and he shoots it all the way down the ice. Now behind the goal, Barrett in control. Fed down the far side, and here is Scholey over the line. Lost possession. Picked up now by Batchelder, and back comes Eden Prairie. Threads one through for Holt, and it's knocked away at the last second by Barrett. Played out to center, and now Chaska will gain possession in the zone. Bauer Berry leaves a pass up the slot, and a save by the goaltender on Scholey as Rosenlund had a chance to bail out his defense, and he did there. Scholey picked up the loose puck about 35 feet out and put a shot on goal. Faceoff coming up to the right of Axel Rosenlund. And a faceoff win for Chaska again. Here's a shot from the point, deflected and nearly tipped home by Selton. Original shot by Burkholder. Puck comes around to the near side. Magnuson holds it in along the half wall. Now he comes to the corner. Magnuson takes the bump and feeds it behind the goal. Olmscheid centers and a shot hits the outside of the goal by Snuggerud. Comes high up the slot. Now to the near side, Magnuson. High in the slot, this is Burkholder. Right side, Snuggerud lets one go, and it's blocked. Comes back to the wall. John Middlestad can't clear it. Now here's a two-on-one down low, a centering pass, and they get no shot out of it, as it turns out, but it comes all the way down the ice. 30 seconds to go on the power play. And here for Chaska's Burkholder, ringing the net with a full head of steam, swings past one, comes to center, and he plays a two-man game with Olmscheid over the line. Olmscheid tries to thread it through and just missed the net to the goaltender's right. Puck comes off the boards, and it's picked up by Eden Prairie, carried to center by Steves with 10 seconds in the power play, played in deep. Wishart sets it up behind the goal, and it's picked up by Magnuson. In the right corner, now back behind the net, 13-10 to go. In the second period, as Eden Prairie comes back to full strength, they've killed off the penalty. Now play it over the line. Will Chaska, and there's a high hit on Snuggerud, comes up the slot, and it's played back to center ice. Chaska picks it up, and they'll back into their zone. Rink wide to the near side, Barrett to Burkholder. Now back around on the far side, too far for Scholey, and they'll run after it. And it was tipped. He did get a piece of it, so there's no icing. Comes around behind the net, and it's banked to the near wall. Played ahead by Jorgensen to center. First touch, and over the line comes Luloff. He centers. It's bouncing, and it's steered off to the near side boards. Tipped ahead, and back out to center by Chaska's Charlie Goodrich. Now played to the left side. Picked up by Jorgensen for Eden Prairie, and played into the zone. Rink wide. Chaska has it. A long pass up the middle is tipped ahead by Owen Thomas into the right corner. Langfels goes to the wall with him. Thomas tries to dig it out as he falls. Now he gets back up, trying to thread one through behind the net for Scholey, and it comes to the left wall. Here comes Eden Prairie to center. Down the far wing, Luloff lost it in the center circle. Carrying on is Langenbrunner. Over the line, feeds to the left. Luloff takes it in deep, and he shoots, and he missed the net wide to the right. In the left corner, picked up by Chaska's Berry, and now a pass outlet is stolen away, and here's Jorgensen in deep. He centers to the circle. Batchelder misses wide left. Now Brown along the wall, returns it down to the corner, and chasing after it, Batchelder getting there first is Barrett for Chaska in the left corner, and he'll play it behind the net for Lynch. Up the far wall for Jax. They can't get it out. Shot comes all the way through to the near side boards, and Brown in the corner. Comes out the far side, 11:27 to go in the period. Comes to the right point, and it's going to be held in at the point and played down around behind. It'll come to the near side, and Eden Prairie putting on some pressure. There's a shot. A Wishart fought it off, and he made the save on Riku Brown, who had beaten him earlier. Well, he got his revenge there. Faceoff coming up in the Chaska zone. Now it's played back behind the net, and a faceoff win for Eden Prairie. Comes to the left point, and now Chaska's able to break out through the middle. They'll come over the line. Snuggerud leaves a drop to the left. Here's a shot that doesn't get through from Olmscheid, and Eden Prairie breaks back down the near wing. Stansberry over the line. He plays it towards the net. It's right on to Wishart, and we're going to get a faceoff as Stansberry crashed in looking for a rebound. We have played 6 minutes and 10 seconds of period number two. We remain tied at one. Monticello River Lakes 3-3 tie today. Rogers over the Minneapolis Novas 4-2. Providence Academy 5-0 over Spring Lake Park in early games today. Now Snuggerud plays it ahead for Chaska, and they work towards the net. It's going to be steered back behind by Langfels for Eden Prairie. Back out to center. Magnuson for Chaska reverses back up the wall. In the center circle, Snuggerud has control, and he will peel off. And he makes Steve's miss. Now Jimmy Snuggerud over the line. Feeds the left for Olmscheid. Too far. Loose along the half boards. And players from both teams will go in there for it. And Olmscheid tries to dig it out. Now here comes Steve's away down the ring. Steves cuts to the slot, and his shot is deflected by Burkholder wide. Centering pass comes up the slot. Eden Prairie is changing, and they can't hold the zone. Now it's shot back in rink wide to the far side. And Rinzel goes back behind the Chaska net. Delayed offside coming, now taken off. And with under 10 minutes to go in the period, it's banked ahead to center, and here comes Chaska. This is Scholey over the line. He takes a shot, and a blocker pad save by Rosenlund. Scholey followed his shot, steered it behind the net, and it's controlled by Pergand. Feeds to the far side. Chaska trying to hold the zone. It comes out to center. Pergand over skates. Loose in the center circle. Now it's picked up by Reagan Shepard over the line, and he lost out. Lynch in the right corner for Chaska. Reverses to the left point. Held in. Here's a shot blocked over the top of the cage by Wishart. Cleared to the near side. And now it'll run behind the net. Burkholder after it for Chaska in a physical battle with Shepard. Now the puck comes to the wall. Shepard throws a bump, comes out with a puck. He shoots and a save by Wishart behind the net. Shepard plays it down with the glove and takes a high hit from Burkholder. Now the puck to the near wall, runs to the right point, and here's a shot by the junior defenseman Jake Casey that winds up going over the glass and out of play. 9:03 to go in period number two. Minnehaha Academy losing to Bloomington Kennedy 6-5 today. Benilde over Lakeville South 6-2. Burnsville over Duluth Marshall 4-2. North Branch wins over West Fargo 7-2. Breck over University School 5-3. In other games today, now Chaska controls with 9 minutes to play in the second period. Pass too far for Barry, and that's going to be offside. They'll play it back in, and we'll have to tag up. Now loose to the far boards, and Brown plays it ahead for Eden Prairie. Chaska drops it back into their zone, and they get possession. Brown at the right side shoots it in, and here's Rinzel. He'll ring the boards for Chaska to the near side looking for Barry, and it runs out to center. And into the Eden Prairie zone. Luke Middlestead is being harassed there, and he'll have to take it behind the net as Bennett Jacks was all over him. Puck to the far side, and now Eden Prairie will try through the middle. Batchelder will carry over the line. Batchelder overskates the puck, carrying on his Holt. He spins and centers from deep, and Brown unable to tip it forward. Here comes Chaska back, 3-on-2 if they hurry. Here's Owen Thomas over the line, drops it, and then couldn't get it back on a return from Barry, who does get it. And now Owen Thomas trying to come in front, and Barry, high in the slot, will backhand it towards the point, and Chaska plays for possession. There's a shot by Burkholder that whizzed right through the crease, and unable to tip it home was Selton, who was standing at the right edge. Now Eden Prairie will try the near side. It's picked up by Holt. Pass will come all the way back into the Chaska zone. No icing, and Burkholder will chase it down behind the net with 7:40 to go in the second period. Long pass for Snuggerud, tipped into the Eden Prairie zone, and Snuggerud will go after it behind the net. He'll come out the near side. Snuggerud still in possession, puts on the brakes, comes to the point, and the shot goes wide off the stick of Magnuson. Into the corner, Langfels for Eden Prairie, plays it down behind the net, and Steves tries to come out. He's having trouble with Snuggerud, who steals it. Snuggerud, backhanded shot, and he lifted it over the top. Boy, a great chance for Jimmy Snuggerud, and a good idea to go short side. 2-on-2, Eden Prairie back. Centering pass is broken up before it can get to Stansberry. And now Snuggerud back for Chaska. Over the line he comes, leaves a drop pass. Closing in Burkholder. He goes in deep, centers it. Snuggerud whacked at it. Follow-up shot. What a stop by the goaltender Rosenlund. And he robbed Olmscheid. Puck comes up the slot. Here comes Eden Prairie back. They have a 3-on-2 with trailers. They come in with a shot, and Wishart makes a stop on Holt. Puck comes to the left of the corner of the Chaska zone, and they play it ahead. End-to-end stuff. Here comes Lavelle. He takes a shot. Missed the net wide. It's on the mesh. Comes off. And now Britton for Eden Prairie. Reverses to the far side. Steves steps around a man and comes to center. And now it's tipped ahead by Stansberry into the zone. Steves takes the shot, missed the net wide. Long carom comes to the right point, held in by Casey. Plays it behind the net for Eden Prairie. Now with 6:18 to go in the period, Eden Prairie centers it. It's picked up there by Scholey. He tries to clear and can't. Now it's broken up at center. Scholey with a nice play there, and he plays it between his feet to get space. Scholey looks to center, and he couldn't get it to Lavelle. Now here comes Jorgensen back over the line. Hits the line, and his shot is blocked wide by Lynch, and it runs around on the dasher behind the net. After it is Barrett on the right corner. Hit thrown there. Now Oliver Jorgensen comes in for Eden Prairie. Comes to the far wall. Picked up there by Jax, and he can't clear. Comes to the left point, and Eden Prairie will whistle one high over the glass and out of play. We finally get a stoppage with 5:44 to go in the second period. It's time for some Powerade. 1-1 the score here at Dakota Arena. North Star Christian Academy strives to develop athletes to become fully devoted followers of Jesus Christ with a foundation built on spiritual development, academic advancement, and athletic excellence. And MAP South Hockey, founded over 13 years ago to provide athletes the opportunity to compete alongside other top players and to be challenged and mentored by elite athletes. For more information, visit mapsouth.hockey. 5.5 to go In the second period of a 1-1 game, and this is a good one here from Dakota Arena. Batchelder along the far wall for Eden Prairie, rink-wise to the near side looking for Busby. It was tipped back to him, and now Luke Middlestead down the left, and here comes Eden Prairie. Over the line, a centering pass. Holt tried to split the defense, comes to the right side, loose, and still in skates. Now Chaska will come away with it. And this is Renzel down the far side. He flips it in, and then he heads to the bench on a change. With 5:04 to go, Eden Prairie will step to center. It's picked up there and played ahead by Langenbrunner. Over the line, Mason Langenbrunner into the circle. He takes a shot right on, and Wishart makes the save with 4:54 to go in the period. Tradition Companies, locally owned and operated, is the parent company to new home builders, golf courses, land development, banking, mortgage, and title services. For more information, visit traditioncompanies.com. And the next time you're looking for a great frozen pizza, choose Brew Pub's Lots of Matzah, the only pizza with a half pound of Wisconsin cheese on every pie. Play in the Chaska zone from the faceoff. It's swung around on the boards. We get a whistle, and we have puck going out of play. Give you an idea of the pace at which this period has been played. This faceoff coming up, with 4:48 to go, will be only the eighth of the period. And it's won by Chaska. They've won five out of the eight in this period. It comes on to Wishart from the faceoff and now steered wide of the goal by Burkholder. Cleared to the right side, and Chaska has to clean up in the middle of their zone when they do so. Here's Lavelle over the line. Lavelle throws it in front, and Snuggerud unable to tip it forward. Now Olmscheid along the wall. Behind the net, Snuggerud goes after it, and Langenbrunner takes it away from him, comes to the left point, and Lynch feeds the circle. Snuggerud then lost possession as he falls. The puck picked up and played in deep. Chasing after it is Olmscheid behind the net, but Langfels gets there first. Behind the net, he takes a hit and goes down behind the goal. Langfels centers, they score! And Chaska has regained the lead, 2-1. 4:07 to go. I shouldn't say regained, they have gained the lead for the first time. And it's Shane Lavelle scoring the goal, and Chaska has the lead. With 4:07 left in the second period. So Chaska has the advantage. Puck down, and get the assist. Lavelle from Olmscheid, and Eden Prairie trails 2-1. They trailed last night against St. Thomas Academy and came back and got a 2-2 tie. Played behind the net. Chaska picks it up. Barrett in the left corner. Plays it around behind the net. And now played in to the right of the goal. Chaska takes it behind. 3.5 minutes to play. And covering up in the left corner there is Scholey for Chaska. He goes down. And now Batchelder feeds it wide of the net to the far side. Comes to the right point. And now here is Eden Prairie. Casey flattens it out. Shoot, save, rebound. And a chance for Brown is stopped by Wishart in close. Now a shot is on to the goaltender from the left point, from Will Britton, and will get a face-off as Eden Prairie makes a bid to get it tied. 3:12 to go in the period. Shots on goal in this session. Chaska has 6, Eden Prairie has 9. For the game, Chaska is still outshot Eden Prairie, 16-12. Now from the draw, in the corner, it's John Middlestad. He is ridden off the puck, picked up by Owen Thomas. Now played back behind the net. Burkholder in the left corner, unable to get there. Stansberry centers. It's picked off, and here comes Chaska back. We have a whistle. We have an injured player in the corner. We're going to have a penalty as Stansberry is slow to get up. And heading to the penalty box for Chaska is Max Burkholder. And Stansberry has regained his feet and is heading off. .14:05 is the time of the penalty. Power play for Eden Prairie, their first of the game. And here's Luke Mittelstad. Roughing is the penalty, and Eden Prairie in possession. Now, Luke Mittelstad at the right point has it. 2:40 to go in the period. Here's a chance for Steves, and he went off the defense. Luke Mittelstad, one-timer by John Mittelstad, deflected, and I think it went on goal. Now behind the net, it's rung around on the far side. Snuggerud picks the opening and shoots it all the way down the ice. Now behind the net, Eden Prairie picks it up. 2:16 to go in the second period. They've got a minute 20 of power play. John Mittelstad feeds the right to Luke. Now a pass, and over the line comes Eden Prairie as Busby feeds the left point. John Mittelstad over to Luke at the right point, feeds it down low, and a center and score! Reagan Shepherd on the power play for Eden Prairie, and we're tied up at two with 1:58 to go. Power play goal for the Eagles, who were converting at 29.6% before that power play, and it only went up from there. We're tied at two. 15:02 is the time of the goal for Reagan Shepherd. And for Eden Prairie, that's his second goal. Steves and Mittelstad. John Mittelstad getting assists. It comes right onto the goaltender from the faceoff. .142 to go in period number two, and Chaska is giving at least as good as they're getting so far. They are tied up with Eden Prairie at 2-2. Faceoff to the right of the goal, and Eden Prairie wins the draw. Now they gain possession. It comes to Langenbrunner at the right point. Slings it over to the left. Here's a shot that goes wide of the goal, and it comes to the near side. Langenbrunner can't hold the zone, and it comes to center. It's picked up by Langfels for Eden Prairie. And his outlet pass is stolen. Snuggerud scores! Picks the top shelf! What a goal by Jimmy Snuggerud! Oh, my goodness! That was utterly gorgeous. Jimmy Snuggerud's 11th goal of the season. Time of the goal, 15:40. Jimmy Snuggerud, who wears his dad's number at the University of Minnesota, finds a way through, and Chaska leads it 3-2, unassisted goal for Snuggerud. And a face-off win. Now the play in the Eden Prairie zone. Here's Owen Thomas. Comes to the near circle with a minute 5 to go, and it's played ahead. Stansberry to the line, and a shot by Casey goes well up into the air. Last minute of play. Now picked off in the corner and fed to the point. Here's Casey at the right point. It hopped on him. Comes to the right point, and it runs along the line. Steves picks it up. John Mittelstad closes in. He takes the shot. That's deflected down. And a play by Lavelle there. Check that. It was Magnuson. Now John Mittelstad to the right point. Casey swings it over to the left. And here's a chance. A shot goes wide, deflected by Stansberry. 30 seconds to go in the period. John Mittelstad reverses down the boards. And a centering pass comes all the way through from John Mittelstad to the far side. Now Steves plays it behind the net. Stansberry looking for help. And it hits the back of the net. And the puck is on the mesh. And we'll get a stoppage with 18.8 seconds to play in period number two. Boy, it's been an interesting contest here. No two ways about that. And Chaska looking to take a lead to the intermission here in the second period. Clean face-off win for Eden Prairie. Here's a drive by Busby right on. And the puck now to the near corner with 10 seconds to go in the session. And now it's dragged into the corner by Chaska's Calvin Barrett with 4 seconds to go. He flips it high in the air, and it goes back to the Eden Prairie zone. And after two periods of play, our score is Chaska 3, Eden Prairie 2. Shots on goal in the period. Chaska had 7, two period total of 17. Eden Prairie had 11, a two-period total of 14. Penalty boxes will be empty as we start period number three. Quite a second period here from Dakota Arena. We'll take a break and come back with more. This is Hockey for Life 2019 on the Youth Hockey Hub.
Four years ago, the open field behind Alexandria High School in Alexandria, Minnesota was vacant. The open space abutted by Pioneer Road was nothing more than something to ignore as residents of Alex moved past on their way to two churches, the Midway 9 movie theater, or the Joann Fabrics. But over time, the meadow, which the developers rejected, has become the cornerstone. Under the guidance of Rick and Shannon Randazzo, the North Star Christian Academy has gone from a concept born almost 10 years ago to a rising hockey power in the middle of Minnesota's Central Lakes region.
In 2011, my family and I voyaged out on the 50-state, 50-city tour, which brought our family to all 50 states for 30 days, running hockey camps for youth and adults. A year or so went by, and it brought us to 2013. We are here in Minnesota, and I met with some businessmen, some couples at Tim Cullen's house, and the rest of the story was then became a little bit clearer.
There are 25 players taking classes and playing for the North Star Christian Academy team, hailing from 11 states. North Star's academic team ensures the students are meeting the education requirements for high school graduation, with some students even earning college credit along the way.
So our academic program is very unique in a way because we're bringing in players from all over the country. This year we have 12 different states represented, which means we have to take a look at 12 different high school programs that are going on across the country. We take a look at where the players are at. We try and integrate where they're at to where they want to be. We look forward to the academic goals that they may have, also along with the college goals that they have.
Since coming to North Star, my hockey has just developed and improved tremendously. And before in Fargo, I maybe could have played Division I and gotten noticed, but the chances wouldn't have been as high as when I came here. And now I'm I'm getting a lot more attention and looks, and hopefully my chances to play Division I are a lot higher. So,
while North Star Christian Academy prides itself on a successful hockey start, the development of the whole person is the primary goal of the little school in Alexandria.
So I think that the three main levels of growth that I've had in my life would be the three pillars that we base the school bases itself off of, which is faith, school, and hockey. And I think those have been massive. I think, especially in faith, I mean, we wake up every morning at 7 in the morning, and we have a Devo every morning, so that's huge. Then we're on the ice 2.5 to 3 hours a day, and then we're in the classroom for 5. So we're learning and we're growing in all aspects of our life all the time.
It's a full life for North Star Christian athletes. The Academy's 70,000 square foot athletic facility not only gives the players a place to hone their skills, but it's a touch point for the rest of their day. Serving something higher than yourself takes discipline, sacrifice, and commitment. With the schedules of that Tier 1 teams follow, it would be easy for the players and administrators to lose sight of the Academy's original goal. But between classes, hockey, and traveling around the country for competition, the Knights make it a priority to remind themselves of their ultimate focus.
It's not uncommon to see NHL stars walking through our halls.
What I need, what I think NHL players need, I think it's the premier. It's as good as it gets.
If you look out there, there's 15 to 20 NHL guys any day could be skating.
But they don't sign autographs.
Ready, go!
They're here for the same reason you are. They're a reflection of what passion, hard work, and determination can become.
The younger kids can see what we're doing, and they can see what the older kids are doing, and emulate that to see what it takes to get to the next level.
MAP is the premier hockey development program in the Twin Cities, and the reasons are very clear.
I like coming to MAP because it's very competitive. Everybody comes out here, works their best.
The opportunity is here to take advantage of whatever the individual wants to take advantage of, whether it's on ice, off ice, outside shooting.
So you have everything at your fingertips that you need to be, premier athlete and hockey player.
The intensity is really high, and every day it seems like players are getting better.
Our culture is unique. From peewee to professionals, we demand the same effort from every athlete. And every athlete receives the same world-class treatment.
At MAP Hockey, our sole emphasis should be and is developing high-character athletes.
Our dedicated, decorated staff will help bring your best to the forefront, both on and off the ice.
That competitive atmosphere that we have here is something special.
It's fun seeing the kids work just as hard as we are.
Red, white, blue. Here we go. Let's go.
At MAP Hockey, we are fully supportive and aligned with the Minnesota development model. We encourage athletes to stay home, develop their skills, and play for their community.
We want to put every kid in a position to have success. We kind of put the emphasis on the individual to, create their own career.
When you walk through these doors, be ready to commit to something bigger than yourself.
I'm TJ Oshie, and this is MAP Hockey.
I'm Justin Falk, and this is MAP Hockey.
I'm JT Brown, and this is MAP Hockey.
This is MAP Hockey.
We'll be right back.
4 years ago, the open field behind Alexandria High School in Alexandria, Minnesota was vacant. The open space abutted by Pioneer Road was nothing more than something to ignore as residents of Alex moved past on their way to two churches, the Midway 9 movie theater, or the Joann Fabrics. But over time, the meadow, which the developers rejected, has become the cornerstone. Under the guidance of Rick and Shannon Randazzo, the North Star Christian Academy has gone from a concept born almost 10 years ago to a rising hockey power in the middle of Minnesota's Central Lakes region.
In 2011, my family and I voyaged out on the 50-state, 50-city tour, which brought our family to all 50 states for 30 days, running hockey camps for youth and adults. A year or so went by, and it brought us to 2013. We are here in Minnesota, and I met with some businessmen, some couples at Tim Cullen's house, and the rest of the story was then became a little bit clearer.
There are 25 players taking classes and playing for the North Star Christian Academy team, hailing from 11 states. North Star's academic team ensures the students are meeting the education requirements for high school graduation, with some students even earning college credit along the way.
So our academic program is very unique in a way because we're bringing in players from all over the country. This year we have 12 different states represented, which means we have to take a look at 12 different high school programs that are going on across the country. We take a look at where the players are at. We try and integrate where they're at to where they want to be. We look forward to the academic goals that they may have, also along with the college goals that they have.
Since coming to North Star, my hockey has just developed and improved tremendously. And before in Fargo, I maybe could have played Division I and gotten noticed, but the chances wouldn't have been as high as when I came here. And now I'm getting a lot more attention and looks, and hopefully my chances to play Division I are a lot higher. So,
while North Star Christian Academy prides itself on a successful hockey start, the development of the whole person is the primary goal of the little school in Alexandria.
So I think that the three main levels of growth that I've had in my life would be the three pillars that we base the school bases itself off of, which is faith, school, and hockey. And I think those have been massive. I think, especially in faith, I mean, we wake up every morning at 7 in the morning and we have a Devo every morning. So that's huge. Then we're on the ice 2.5 to 3 hours a day. And then we're in the classroom for 5. So we're learning and we're growing in all aspects of our life all the time.
It's a full life for North Star Christian athletes. The Academy's 70,000 square foot athletic facility not only gives the players a place to hone their skills, but it's a touch point for the rest of their day. Serving something higher than yourself takes discipline, sacrifice, and commitment. With the schedules of that Tier 1 teams follow, it would be easy for the players and administrators to lose sight of the Academy's original goal. But between classes, hockey, and traveling around the country for competition, the Knights make it a priority to remind themselves of their ultimate focus.
Back at Dakota Arena, ready for the third period. Chaska has the lead over Eden Prairie, 3-2. And Chaska works left to right as we call period number three for you. Lavelle, who has a goal on against John Middlestad, the faceoff controlled by Chaska, and the third period is underway. Lavelle at center plays it over the Eden Prairie line. Backhanded centering pass comes through to the near side boards off the goaltender. Steves over the Chaska line, shoots, trying to go through a screen, loose at the right edge. And now played behind the net, Steves will pick it up. He centers it. John Middlestad shoots. He's over the top. Rebound off the end wall, and quickly the goaltender, Wishart, was able to get a stoppage. 29 seconds into the third period. Take your game to the edge. Sniper's Edge Hockey was the original and continues to be the leader in bringing the best hockey training aids to players from mites to pros. Check out Sniper's Edge this weekend for tons of savings. Busby shoots from the faceoff, and that's blocked. Here comes Snuggerud back, the man of the moment for Chaska. Now cleared down the near side and into the zone. Back behind the net, Langenbrunner rings the net for Eden Prairie. And here they come down the far wing. John Middlestad over the line. He is taken in against the wall, picked up by Scholey and now fed to the near side. And a bump there. Puck comes out to center and it's picked up by Stansberry for Eden Prairie. Banks it off the boards, picked up by Lynch, who plays it into the Eden Prairie zone. Set up by the goaltender Rosenlund behind the net. And now spinning there, Luke Middlestad had it stripped off his stick and it's picked up by Snuggerud. And the last time he did that, it was a tie-breaking goal. Now here comes Eden Prairie down the wing as Snuggerud heads off on a line change. Now it's back into the Chaska zone, and the Hawks will try the near side. It's picked up by Owen Thomas, cleared to the near side, and it's held in there by Reagan Shepard, who has a goal on the power play. Eden Prairie plays it down low, Batchelder, and it's cleared away from him in the corner. Lynch picks it up for Chaska, feeds it up the near wing boards, and it's played out to center by Jax. Relayed back in, and now it's chopped off the wall, and here's a race for it in the zone, and here's Barry going after it in the Eden Prairie zone. He stops, he looks for help, his centering pass is blocked, he followed it. Barry comes to the far side, still in possession, dueling with Stansberry behind the net, and now he's ridden off the puck finally. It's picked up and cleared to center, and it's in the skates there of Jax, who clears to the far side. Eden Prairie plays it in, and here's Steves cutting to the slot, knocked off his stick there. Rebound off the inboards. He's dueling with Magnuson now, and they go to the board. Steves comes out with a puck. He feeds the puck to Busby. Top of the right circle, a centering pass is deflected by Pergand behind the net, and players from both teams in after it. It's dug out by Magnuson. Middle breakout for Chaska. Here they come down the far wing. As played ahead by Barry, and he's ridden off. Busby claims it for Eden Prairie. Now a pass down the right, and here comes Eden Prairie back with Pergand shooting it in. It rings the boards. Burkholder in the right corner for Chaska. He'll send it to the left point. It gets past Busby, and now carrying on is Lovell. He's got a two-on-one. Lovell in deep. Centers it! Oh, and a top shot. It was a great opportunity, and Rosenlund was given time to get over, and a terrific opportunity for Charlie Goodrich. But he did not get good wood on the shot. We'll take a faceoff in the Eden Prairie zone, and the Eagles control, 14-12 to go in the third period. Puck comes to center, and it's turned back. Here comes Chaska again. Lavelle in against the boards. They fall down, and it's played on out to center. Two against two, but Chaska's able to clean up. In their zone, this is Burkholder on the near side. He'll rink wide one. It's going to come back to the Eden Prairie blue line. Picked up there. And now it's Luke Middlestad over the line. Puts it on goal. And now Burkholder in the near corner. Plays it ahead. And here's Snuggerud down the wing. He's got half a step. Snuggerud cuts in. Through a screen. Shoots. And he put it right on goal. Stansberry, the defender there, was used by Snuggerud as a screen on that shot. Comes out to center. And Burkholder has it there, and he rink-wides it back in. Stansberry will claim it behind the net. 13:20 to play. Stansberry in the left corner. Pass is too far for Luke Middlestad. Turned back by Barrett back into the Eden Prairie zone. Into the left corner with 13:12 to play. Now behind the net, Stansberry comes out the right side, draws the forecheck and feeds the right. Now a pass is deflected before it gets to Batchelder, but Shepard carries on, and his shot goes off the defenseman Barrett on that side. Now Chaska will play to center. Here they come with Rinzel, and he'll backhand it forward into the Eden Prairie zone. Come around to the far side, and Langfell's in the corner. Tries to play it ahead. Holt, one-touch pass, and here they come. Batchelder down the far wing. Cuts to the slot. He shoots right on, and Wishart makes the save. Face-off coming up to his right. 12:41 to go in the third, and Chaska holding a 3-2 lead as they bid for an upset here against Eden Prairie, which saw its perfect start to the season come to an end last night, though they didn't lose. There was a 2-2 tie against St. Thomas Academy, and a trail in the third period here. Faceoff for Eden Prairie is pulled between the point men all the way back into the Eden Prairie zone, and it's fed ahead. Here comes Pergand. Feeds the far side. Now it's carried over the line by Steves. Poke checked away. Comes to the right point. Pergand carries on. In the left corner, Magnuson reverses it up the wall. And it comes out to center. And here's a chance for Chaska. Two on one if they hurry. And over the line they come. A shot and a save made there as Barry whistled one on goal. Now the puck comes to the near side. It's picked up and back comes Steves. We have a whistle and we have a hand pass called. And that is going to bring it all the way back in the Eden Prairie zone for a faceoff with 12-10 to go in the third period. Again, explosive stuff here. It's been a pretty good high school hockey game here this afternoon. Lavelle on for the faceoff. Lost the draw, cleared back behind the net, and Eden Prairie will control. And a broken stick knocked out the neutral ice as a shot from the point comes in by Barrett. Save made by Rosenlund. Puck now to the near side boards. Crashing in there is Lynch, and he's deep in the corner. He's taken to the boards there by Luke Mittelstadt. And here comes Eden Prairie to center. And Batchelder over the line. He shoots. Wishart saves. Big rebound, and Shepard couldn't get to it. Now along the near wall, it's poked to the near side and played out to center. And here they come. Scholey over the line. He left a drop pass, and Lavelle's shot is stopped. Back comes Eden Prairie, three against three. Over the line they come, and a poke check. Here's a follow-up shot by Luke Mittelstadt, and a save by Wishart. Puck comes back out to center, and Stansberry for Eden Prairie. And turning with it there is Batchelder over the line. He takes a shot. Wishart makes the save, and he tried to stick the rebound away. Snuggerud claims it in the right corner for Chaska. Long pass comes out to center and comes right back in the zone. They're going to be offside, so they have to tag. Now here comes Chaska. Eden Prairie is changing. Down the near wing, Barrett comes to the slot. Tried to split the defense. Goes in. Left it there. It comes up the slot. And a backhanded centering pass in front. They whack away at it and loose at the left edge. And a faceoff coming up as Selton came close. And Selton was the fella that had a goal taken away in the second period on that quick whistle in front of the Eden Prairie goal. And he came close again there. 10:52 to go in the third period. And Chaska leads Eden Prairie 3-2. Owen Thomas on for the faceoff for Chaska. Riku Brown is out there. Chaska wins the draw. Comes to Owen Thomas. Check that. Rinzel. Now a centering pass comes through to the far side wall. Magnuson goes behind the net. And Chaska from deep looking to center it. Barry took a shot. Hit the outside of the net. Loose in the left corner. And Brown plays it ahead. And here comes Tyler Johnson down the near wing. Over the line. Now Luloff looks to center it. And behind the net, Tyler Johnson comes out the far side. Puck bouncing. And it's picked up by Chaska. And here comes Owen Thomas down the left. Over the line. Left a drop pass. And that was deflected by the defenseman. Barry plays to the line. It's running along the blue line. Played back in offside. And Chaska takes off the delayed offside. Now here's a play by Thomas to steal the puck. And he centers it. It goes off the defense and out of play. And a Chaska player winds up in the net on top of it, so the players aren't supposed to go there. The puck is 10:03 to go. We're brought to you by Tradition Companies, locally owned and operated, the parent company to new home builders, golf courses, and land development, banking, mortgage, and title services. For more information, traditioncompanies.com. Comes out to center. Here's John Mittelstadt over the line for Eden Prairie. His pass is picked off by Scholey, and he'll go back behind the net. For Chaska, swings it around on the boards. It comes out to center. Luke Mittelstadt intercepts. Under 10 minutes to play. And now it's played back in by Eden Prairie from their own side of center, and that's icing. So they'll go back for a faceoff. MapSouth Hockey was founded 13 years ago to provide athletes the opportunity to compete alongside other top players and to be challenged and mentored by elite coaches. For more information, visit mapsouth.hockey. Face off to the right of the Eden Prairie goal, and it's controlled by Chaska. Shot from the wing boards by Scholey, almost got through, and comes down the near wing over the line. Steves takes a shot that was blocked, standing up by Burkholder. Comes to the left point, Luke Mittelstadt. Comes to the near side board, swept around behind by John Mittelstadt behind the goal. Steves has it there. He feeds the high slot. John Mittelstadt off towards the right point. Watched there by Scholey. Got around him. Comes to the circle and scores! And Eden Prairie has tied the game. A real pretty effort by John Mittelstadt. And the game is tied with 9:11 to go. Eden Prairie 3, Chaska 3 at 7:49. John Mittelstad scoring the goal that has tied the game for Eden Prairie. That's his seventh goal of the season. It comes at 7:49. And we'll get the scoring on it.
Eden Prairie goal scored by number 9, John Mittelstad. Assist to number 27, Luke Mittelstad. That's John Mittelstad from Luke Mittelstad. Time of the goal, 7:49.
And Luke Mittelstad gets the only assist. Chaska has possession now in deep, a centering pass, and it bounced before it could get to Stelton. And now played out to center. And now we're going to get a whistle and an icing call against Chaska. Look him all the way back to the right of Carter Wishart. Coming up on the halfway mark of the third period. 3-3 with 8:45 to go. Batchelder now dismissed from the faceoff. Shepherd will come in the draw, and Chaska wins it. Cleared, and it comes out to center. Snuggerud in possession, feeds the left. And now down low, Snuggerud trying to control a bouncing puck. It's centered, it comes up the slot. Here's Shepherd for Eden Prairie. One-timer, whistle wide of the goal. Rebound is steered back by Batchelder as Mason Langenbrunner with a good chance there. Loose against the left post, rings around to the near side. And here's Langfels, plays it behind the net. Out of the far side, picked up by Olmscheid, tries to clear. And Eden Prairie takes another turnover down low, centering pass, and they score! And Eden Prairie has come back to take the lead in the third period at the 8:56 mark. And Batchelder, looks like it was his goal, will get a determination, but Eden Prairie has come back and they take the lead 4-3, their first lead in the game since 1-0. So Chaska now with work to do. We'll see if they can do it. They've worked extremely hard today. It is Batchelder. Holt and Langenbrunner get assists on the goal, and it comes to the far side. Chaska tries to break out to center. And play is in the Chaska zone. Eden Prairie with two goals in the third period. Center comes to the right side. Stansberry shoots, and a save made by Wishart in the left corner. Now in the left corner, it's swung around to the near side, and Jax goes after it for Chaska. And now Chaska trying to clear out. It comes to center, and here's Owen Thomas playing it forward. And now it's shot into the zone by Jax. He's taken in against the wall hard by Tyler Johnson. And now here's a turnover down deep, and Thomas unable to drag the puck to the edge of the crease. It hits a water bottle laying on the ice. And now over the line comes Eden Prairie going in and sweeping just wide was John Mittelstad. Puck picked up by Pergand, and that shot is deflected, and it comes all the way back into the Eden Prairie zone, icing on Chaska, but a water bottle got loose on the Eden Prairie bench, came on the ice, and the puck hit it and deflected right to John Mittelstad, who started a break with it. Not the water bottle. The puck, 6:55 to go. Now it comes to the left point, and Busby plays it down. Behind the net, Bergand lost possession. Barrett plays it over to the left, and now here comes Chaska through the middle. Lavelle over the line. Lavelle leaves a drop pass. Scholey couldn't get a shot away. Sweeps it towards the front of the net. Now up the slot it comes. There's a shot. They score! Yes! Rebound is in the net! And Chaska, I thought the first one had gone in, but Lavelle picked the puck up and made sure. 6:34 to go, and we're even at four. For now, I'd say Lavelle. I thought the first shot from the point went in, but Chaska does get a tying goal. And if it's Lavelle, it'll be his second of the game and sixth of the year. And it is Lavelle.
Magnuson
gets the assist. Batchelder back for Eden Prairie. And now here's Luke Mittelstad working to his right. And it comes over to the left boards. Still in possession. Now he has ridden off the puck, and Chaska will break out. Comes to the near side. They do get the puck to center. And it's played rink wide and chopped into the zone by Selton. 6 minutes to play. It's been a real good game. Comes over to the right point. Here's Burkholder. Can't get it through. And now the puck is flipped high in the air back deep into the Chaska zone to the left. That'll be icing on Eden Prairie. And the goal for Shane Lavelle. Now in the left corner, Eden Prairie gets a faceoff win and they play at the center. Chaska plays it in, Lavelle, and he has had himself a nice game as well with two goals. 5:18 left in regulation. The puck played in by John Mittelstad and swept back to center, and here comes Chaska down the left. They'll play it ahead from center through Scholey, and it goes behind the net. Rosenlund out to play it, feeds the left, and now Steves down the near wing. Getting there first for Chaska is Calvin Barrett. Now over the line, Steves angles into the right. He'll close in, backhanded shot. Wishart makes the save. It was right in his chest. And he gets the glove down to smother the rebound with 4:55 to go. This has been a very entertaining game. Four goals on 25 shots for Chaska. Four goals on 23 shots for Eden Prairie. Faceoff coming up to the left. And Chaska's lost their centerman on this draw. The puck comes over to the far side, and it's controlled by Eden Prairie. Under 5 minutes left in the third period. They'll battle for it along the boards. And it's swung around behind the net by Owen Thomas to the far side. And out to center it comes. Johnson back in the zone rink wide to Langfels up to center. And Brown plays it forward into the Chaska zone. Now in the left corner, Magnuson swings it around towards the right point, held in by Brown there, and he'll backhand it back behind the net. Jorgensen goes after it, and he is squeezed off beautifully there by Barrett. Now here comes Chaska down the near wing. Jax hits the blue line and shoots it in and heads for the bench as they change. 4:10 left in the third. Now a pass to the far side, picked up by Holt. He relays to center, and here comes Batchelder over the line. Batchelder centers it. Holt picks it up. He fires, and he missed the net wide to the left. Long carom. Luke Mittelstad shot his block. Came back to him, and then he put one through to the far side. Batchelder after it. Comes to the right point. Stansberry didn't get good wood on it. Now a play up the middle. Tipped ahead. Breakaway. Snuggerud going in on goal. Snuggerud shoots, and he tried to backhand it. Ah, that would have been a goal of the season if Jimmy Snuggerud would have been able to pull that one off. He tried to pull the puck forward and then tuck it in on the backhand behind Axel Rosenlund. And that would have been spectacular. His goal in the second period was a roof raiser, but that one would have been special. Now Eden Prairie controls from the faceoff. Now it comes around to the far side, picked up by Selton, and he feeds the far corner. Stansberry plays it ahead. And here's Lynch at center for Chaska. Rink wides to Burkholder. Back to Lynch. 3:25 left. Plays to the near side. Selton now to Snuggerud, who will circle back. Jimmy Snuggerud now feeds the left. Lovely pass picked up by Selton. Cuts to the slot, shoots, and the rebound off the inboards. Picked up there. And Luke Mittelstad fears it around. Here's a chance by Snuggerud, and it went off something wide. And it went straight down before it got to the goal, and now picked up. Here comes Steves down the near wing for Eden Prairie. Plays it in to the Chaska zone, and chasing after it, Joe Lynch comes around the far side. 2:55 left, pass to center, picked off by Stansberry. And over the line they come. Steves takes a shot, had a good idea there, and he shot it over the top of the net. Busby feeds it right back in. Wishart unable to fully cut it off. It comes to the right corner, and Chaska will play it ahead, played with a glove, and kicked to center. And now it'll be Busby claiming for Eden Prairie. 2:34 to go. Busby, the near side, picked up, and now here comes Scholey over the line, and then he tried to cut to the slot and couldn't get there. Now Scholey in to try and fish it out. The puck comes back to Magnuson in the Chaska zone. One touch pass to the far side. 2:20 left, and it's passed to center. Picked up by Busby for Eden Prairie. And now cleared ahead. Picked up there by Reagan Shepard across to the far side, and Rinzel takes it back into his zone. And Chaska will clean up in their own end. Now an outlet pass stolen by Shepard, but carrying on was Barrett. Now loose to the neutral ice area, and it's picked up by Eden Prairie. Shot on in. Wishart makes the save, and he'll elect to get the stoppage with 1:54 left. And a 4-4 tie here in the third period with 1:54 left in regulation. Now from the faceoff, it's controlled by Chaska, and they will play to center with 1:45 to go. Over the line they come. Magnuson in deep behind the net. Magnuson then left it behind the net, and Eden Prairie is going to pick that off. Loose at the right edge though, and Chaska's Olmscheid tried to sweep it in front and couldn't. Here comes Eden Prairie back, 90 seconds to go. This is Steves, who seems like he's been out there all day. Steves shoots, save, Wishart, rebound! Oh, and a stop by Wishart, follow-up, and that goes off the defense. Eden Prairie so close. John Middlestead had the rebound chance. Now a shot goes over the top. Luke Middlestead tries to center. It runs to the near circle and picked behind the net. There's a check in the left corner picked up by Magnuson, and he clears it. It's going to bounce back to Eden Prairie's blue line. And with 1:02 to go, it comes back into the Chaska zone. Burkholder in the left corner, rings the net with it, plays it ahead, and it's going to go all the way down the ice. So an icing call against Chaska with 52.3 seconds to go. We'll face off to the right of Wishart. And it has been a fine third period here as well. Shots 26-25 for Chaska. And they have stood toe-to-toe with Eden Prairie all day. Played around on the far side. And here's Lavelle down the wing. The two-goal man hits the Eden Prairie line. Tried to cut to the slot. Ran off his stick. And Eden Prairie picks it up. Here's Batchelder back over the Chaska line. Batchelder is going to be forced wide by Burkholder. Centers, and it comes through to the far side. Here's a race for it. And picked up by Lavelle down the wing. He cuts to the slot. Lavelle closes in. Looks to center. And he had a man open at the right edge and couldn't get it to him. 25 seconds to go. Here's Batchelder ahead to Holt. Over the line, and it's rink-wided back to the far side. Batchelder is after it there. He cuts to the slot. He shoots, and it's deflected over the top. Picked up now by Steves in the near corner. Left point it comes, and it's Batchelder. Now a centering pass. Holt had it picked off with 7 seconds to go. It's cleared all the way down the ice. That will be icing with 3.5 seconds to go against Chaska. So there's going to be an offensive zone faceoff for Eden Prairie in regulation. And we'll draw to the right of Carter Wishart. It'll be John Middlestead on for the draw against Barry. Faceoff comes to the corner, and that will do it for regulation time. And for the second straight day, Eden Prairie is forced to overtime. For the second straight day, Chaska is forced to overtime. After three periods, our score is Eden Prairie 4, Chaska 4. Shots are 26-25 for Chaska, which means they had 9 shots in the third period. Eden Prairie with 11 for a three-period total of 25. We'll take a break and come back with the overtime next. This is Hockey for Life 2019 on the Youth Hockey Hub.
It's not uncommon to see NHL stars walking through our halls.
What I need, what I think NHL players need, I think it's the premier. It's as good as it gets.
If you look out there, there's 15 to 20 NHL guys any day could be skating.
But they don't sign autographs.
Ready, go!
They're here for the same reason you are. They're a reflection of what passion, hard work, and determination can become.
The younger kids can see what we're doing, and they can see what the older kids are doing, and emulate that to see what it takes to get to the next level.
MAP is the premier hockey development program in the Twin Cities, and the reasons are very clear.
I like coming to MAP because it's very competitive. Everybody comes out here, works their best.
The opportunity is here to take advantage of whatever the individual wants to take advantage of, whether it's on ice, off ice, outside shootings.
You have everything at your fingertips that you need to be, you know, premier athlete and hockey player.
The intensity is really high, and every day it seems like players are getting better.
Our culture is unique. From peewee to professionals, we demand the same effort from every athlete. And every athlete receives the same world-class treatment.
At MAP Hockey, our sole emphasis should be and is developing high-character athletes.
Our dedicated, decorated staff will help bring your best to the forefront, both on and off the ice.
That competitive atmosphere that we have here is something special.
It's fun seeing the kids work just as hard as we are.
Red, white, blue. Here we go. Let's go.
At MAP Hockey, we are fully supportive and aligned with the Minnesota development model. We encourage athletes to stay home, develop their skills, and play for their community.
We want to put every kid in a position to have success. We kind of put the emphasis on the individual to, you know, create their own career.
When you walk through these doors, be ready to commit to something bigger than yourself.
I'm TJ Oshie, and this is MAP Hockey.
I'm Justin Falk, and this is MAP Hockey.
I'm JT Brown, and this is MAP Hockey.
This is MAP Hockey.
Back at Dakota Arena, Jeff Papas with the call of overtime. Chaska and Eden Prairie deadlocked at four. It's been a very good game, and Eden Prairie wins the faceoff at the start of overtime, and they'll play it into the Chaska zone. They'll work left to right as we call the overtime period for you. 8 minutes on the board. Wishart sets it up behind the goal, and Chaska's Burkholder feeds the far side, and it comes out to center. And now run on to there by Pergand, and it goes over the boards and into the Eden Prairie bench for a stoppage. 7:41 to go. Shots 26-25 for Chaska. By periods, 3-11-11 for Eden Prairie, 10-7-9 for Chaska. It's a young Chaska team. I mean, let's be honest about it. Rinzel gets a regular shift. He's a freshman. Wishart, the goaltender, is a freshman. Snuggerud, the leading scorer, is a freshman. Burkholder is a sophomore. The puck-moving defenseman that they have, it's a pretty good one. And their best is yet to come, but right now they have Eden Prairie in overtime. Great experience for that team, regardless of the outcome. Snuggerud now comes to the left boards, and it's played by Stansberry to the wall and out to center. Shot back in, and now it'll run towards the near side boards, picked up by Drew Holt, plays it in. Holt looking for Batchelder, and it's going to crawl over the plexiglass, bounced on the top, and wound up in the netting. We'll get a faceoff 46 seconds into overtime. And we will get a draw to the left of Wishart. Eden Prairie, the home team, using the last change here. Clean faceoff win for them. Comes to the near side boards. Now played behind the net, and Eden Prairie swings around. They'll try to jam it at the left edge, and it is Steves. Stopped by Wishart, face-off in the Chaska zone. That ran a few seconds off the clock and will face off again. And another face-off win for Eden Prairie. And now it's played down, and this is Steves, indefatigable, you might say, and Chaska's going to ice the puck. Steve seems like he's been out there all afternoon. He has worked extremely hard for Eden Prairie. He has an assist on the power play goal that they scored in the first period. He's their leading scorer with 14 points. Tied now with John Mittelstad, who had the go-ahead goal in the third period for Eden Prairie. Ooh, there's a shot for the faceoff. It's deflected just wide of the post. And now a follow-up comes in front, and it's cleared out to center. Chaska regroups there. And they'll play it ahead. Comes to the near side boards. And now it's played on into the Eden Prairie zone. And Rosenland sets it up. Now they'll ring the boards. Luloff leaves it behind the goal for Stansberry. Pass to the left, and here comes Eden Prairie. Luloff will carry it over the line. Takes it wide, and it's knocked off his stick by Magnuson. But again, the ever-present Steves feeds the far circle. Now a centering pass, and a trigger man, Luke Middlestad, unable to get a shot away, loose at the right edge of the goal, and now cleared back behind the net. Eden Prairie with 6 minutes to go in overtime in possession. Cuts to the slot, and a shot is deflected over the glass and out of play by Holt, and we'll get a faceoff in the Chaska zone. 2 minutes, 5 seconds gone in overtime. You're in a 4-4 tie. Eden Prairie tied yesterday with St. Thomas Academy. They play Moorhead tomorrow, and there's a shot from the faceoff deflected as an Eden Prairie player crashes through the goal crease. And now comes out to center. Now Chaska will come in. A drop pass. A shot whistled just wide of the goal by Scholey. Now loose in the right corner. Lavelle behind the net. Played around to the right side. Rinzel holds it in. Along the wall, they go back behind the net looking for Lavelle. And it's dug out. Scholey behind the goal looking for Lavelle. Cannot get it to him. It runs to Magnuson on the half wall. Plays it around behind the net. Lavelle along the boards. Lost it. Comes to the right point. It's going to be held in there by Goodrich. Fed down low for Scholey. Referee got in the way. And the puck is picked up. Played high in the slot. And a shot by Snuggerud winds up going out of play. And we're going to get a faceoff in the Eden Prairie zone with 5:07 to go. By my count, Chaska hasn't won a faceoff in the overtime. And they still haven't as Eden Prairie gets possession on the near side. Here's Pergand up the near wall, comes out to center. And a shot deflected down in front and tipped away to the right boards. John Middlestad unable to play it out. Here's Luke Middlestad shooting, and that goes wide. And that's golf, but the referee has been in the line of fire here in the overtime period. Now it comes out to the right point. Stansberry feeds it across. Luke Middlestad shoots. It goes off Wishart and over the top. 4:38 to go. Now behind the net, it's John Middlestad feeding it to Luke Middlestad. Across, they score! Game over! Ben Steves wins it for Eden Prairie. And a 5-4 overtime win for Eden Prairie that they had to earn. Time of the overtime goal is 3 minutes and 29 seconds. And it is Ben Steves scoring for Eden Prairie to win the game by 5-4. Steves' ninth goal of the season. Canyon Pergand and John Middlestad assist on the goal. Final shots 28-26 Eden Prairie, which means Chaska had no shots in the overtime, and Eden Prairie had three for a game total of 28, 5-4 the score. And what a game. Eden Prairie survives, and they go to 8 wins, no losses, and a tie. Chaska to 5-6-1, but a difficult loss and a great effort by Chaska this afternoon. That'll do it for us here from Dakota Arena, back with our last game of the night. Edina and St. Thomas Academy at 7:30. This is Hockey for Life 2019 on the Youth Hockey Hub.
4 years ago, the open field behind Alexandria High School in Alexandria, Minnesota was vacant. The open space abutted by Pioneer Road was nothing more than something to ignore as residents of Alex moved past on their way to two churches, the Midway 9 movie theater, or the Joanne Fabrics. But over time, the meadow, which the developers rejected, has become the cornerstone. Under the guidance of Rick and Shannon Randazzo, the North Star Christian Academy has gone from a concept born almost 10 years ago to a rising hockey power in the middle of Minnesota's Central Lakes region.
In 2011, my family and I voyaged out on the 50-state, 50-city tour, which brought our family to all 50 states for 30 days, running hockey camps for youth and adults. A year or so went by, and it brought us to 2013. We were here in Minnesota, and I met with some businessmen, some couples, at Tim Cullen's house, and the rest of the story was then became a little bit clearer.
There are 25 players taking classes and playing for the North Star Christian Academy team, hailing from 11 states. North Star's academic team ensures the students are meeting the education requirements for high school graduation, with some students even earning college credit along the way.
So our academic program is very unique in a way because we're bringing in players from all over the country. This year we have 12 different states represented, which means we have to take a look at 12 different high school programs that are going on across the country. We take a look at where the players are at. We try and integrate where they're at to where they want to be. We look forward to the academic goals that they may have, also along with the college goals that they have.
Since coming to North Star, my hockey has just developed and improved tremendously. And before in Fargo, I maybe could have played Division I and gotten noticed, but the chances wouldn't have been as high as when I came here. And now I'm getting a lot more attention and looks, and hopefully my chances to play Division I are a lot higher. So,
while North Star Christian Academy prides itself on a successful hockey start, the development of the whole person is the primary goal of the little school in Alexandria.
So I think that the three main levels of growth that I've had in my life would be the three pillars that we base the school bases itself off of, which is faith, God, or faith, school, and hockey. And I think those have been massive. I think, especially in faith, I mean, we wake up every morning at 7 in the morning and we have a Devo every morning, so that's huge. Then we're on the ice 2.5 to 3 hours a day, and then we're in the classroom for 5. So We're learning and we're growing in all aspects of our life all the time.
It's a full life for North Star Christian athletes. The Academy's 70,000 square foot athletic facility not only gives the players a place to hone their skills, but it's a touch point for the rest of their day. Serving something higher than yourself takes discipline, sacrifice, and commitment. With the schedules of that Tier 1 teams follow, it would be easy for the players and administrators to lose sight of the Academy's original goal. But between classes, hockey, and traveling around the country for competition, the Knights make it a priority to remind themselves of their ultimate focus.